Hey guys, what's up and welcome back to my channel. Now if you just happen to stumble onto this video and you're new here, hi, I'm Candace, and on my channel we talk about motherhood, beauty, lifestyle. I also do some vlogging, so if that sounds like your jam, go ahead and hit that subscribe button now, and don't forget to turn on that notification bell so you're alerted every time I upload a new video. So as you can see from the title, today's video is going to be a cook with me video, and we're going to be making some lasagna. Now for my lasagna, I use ground turkey as well as Italian sausage. So if you're not really feeling that, you can definitely swap that out for like ground beef or whatever your taste buds desire. Go ahead, feel free to tweak it to your liking. I don't want this to be a long and drawn out intro, but if you guys like this video and you'd like to see more of this type of video, feel free to comment down below, and we're just gonna go right ahead and jump into the video.
I start with filling up my pot of water so that that can start boiling while I'm doing everything else, and I just put a pan on the stove so that that can start warming up. Once you've got your pan to the proper temperature, go ahead and unpackage your meat. I'm using ground turkey and ground Italian sausage. You can use ground beef, whatever you like. I love adding a little bit of mild or hot Italian sausage to just give it a little bit of a kick. Once you've got that in your pan, go ahead and mix it all up, and then I'm just gonna add a few seasonings. It really doesn't take a lot because that Italian sausage has a really nice taste to it already. So just a little bit of seasoning goes a long way. Once you've got that mixed up all good and it's nice and brown, you're just gonna go ahead and strain it into a strainer, making sure to get all those juices and oils out of there. Then go ahead and dump it right back into the same pan because now we're gonna go ahead and add some sauce. I'm using Prego fresh mushroom. You can use whichever sauce you desire, or you can make a homemade sauce. I have a two-year-old running around at home, so I don't have time for homemade sauces right now. We're just gonna go ahead and use the jar. I'm adding a little more seasoning now to my sauce just to get it the right flavor that I like, and you can really play around with that part. Go ahead and turn your stove down to its low setting and let that sauce simmer. While that's simmering, you can go ahead and add in a big bowl your spinach, ricotta cheese, eggs, and just a little salt and pepper to taste. You wanna mix that up really, really well. Now remember that pot of water that we put on in the beginning? It should be boiling now, so you wanna go ahead and just dump your lasagna noodles into that and let that start cooking. Once those noodles are done, go ahead and strain those and move on to layering your lasagna. Start off with a thin layer of your sauce on the bottom of the pan. Once you have that spread out evenly, go ahead and grab those noodles, and you should be able to get about three of them across your pan, depending on the size of pan that you're using. On top of the noodles, spread that ricotta mix, the ricotta spinach mix that we went ahead and mixed up, and then you're gonna put your sauce right on top of that. So you just wanna do thin layers of all these things, and you wanna just keep repeating those steps. I like to try and get at least three layers of the noodles in there. Depending on the type of pan that I'm using, sometimes it'll only allow me to do two, but three is ideal. Once you get to the top of your pan and you've done your last layer of sauce, I go ahead and add mozzarella cheese all over, and I also mix it in with a little bit of Parmesan cheese as well. Cover your lasagna pan with aluminum foil, leaving a little extra space so that your cheese doesn't stick to the foil. Then go ahead and set your oven to 475 degrees for the temperature and pop that lasagna in there. Add some foil or a sheet pan underneath your lasagna in case it drips. Leave it in the oven for about an hour to hour and a half. For the last 15 minutes, remove the foil and let the cheese brown, and then bon appetit. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and see you next time.